the history of the church in India. As you are aware, Christians are persecuted and hunted down in different states of India, especially in Orissa and Karnataka, and churches and Christian homes are destroyed and burnt. Priests, sisters, pastors, and people are killed for no cause except that they are Christians. Every day, we see reports of the exhibition of this indescribable cruelty perpetrated on innocent Christians who have refused, because of their faith in Jesus our Lord, to retaliate. The central and state governments in India are silent onlookers of this wanton rampage. The machinery of the law and order in India has come to a standstill. There is a concerted attempt to wipe away the very trace of Christian faith in two districts in the state of Orissa. Some have proffered lame excuses of conversion, tribal rivalry, economic advancement of Christians, etc., as a cause for this wanton and violent destruction, burning, killing, and looting. How can this be an excuse for killing? Where is the constitutional protection for the innocent? Can the central government of India remain a silent spectator of this atrocious cruelty? More than any other community, Indian Christians have given all their talents and resources to give better education, health care, and care for the poor to India. They have participated in a vigorous and robust way, in spite of being a tiny minority of India's population, which is 2%, to accelerate the social and economic development of India. Who have voted?